Smoke cheaper, cheaper, smoke cheaper, cheaper. You're so hot that I can kiss the sky.
You knew we were coming back. We always come back. We float down here. Welcome back to the episode of Get Nose on You by RidgeOpolus. Right back at it. Care package, my good man Rat. Rat's Beer Reviews sent me. And next one up, we're staying with the Half Acre. Jenny's there, having a little date night down here. We're playing, cornhole? Mm-hmm. Listening to music. You can see, got the YouTube up behind me. Next, we're going to be playing some tabletop shuffleboard. But she has a drink, so I'm going to get one in. And this is Half Acre Beer. So this will be number 5. This is called Tuna Pale Ale. And this is a low guy, 4.7% ABV. I can't remember the last time I had a 4.7% ABV. And does anything about hop?
Don't knock the little guy.
What does that mean? Jenny's walling out. That's the can art right there. I don't know, even know what the can art. What would you call that can art right there? It's like algae on something? Looks like algae on rocks or something.
Half acre beer called tuna.
No, the picture.
Yes. Doesn't that look like a fish?
Yeah, but it's like there's algae on it or something. Like the green at the bottom. I don't know. Let's get a little white. Snap some tin. A man rat. Oh, it's real clear. This is a Jenny beer. She might steal this one from me. She loves the 4.7s.
Why are you saying that? I like 6.7.
No, you like Blue Moon and stuff.
On average at home, but if we go to a restaurant, I look for the 6-point-somethings.
You like low ABV beers? Of course you do. What's the other ones you like? Heineken, Red Stripe.
I told you to not buy any more Heineken.
Okay.
When was the last time we had a case of Heineken's here?
Well, if I'm going mainstream, I like that's what I like. I'll drink a Heineken, I'll drink
the
a Red
Heineken's
Stripe.
Do absolutely nothing to me.
All right. This is definitely see-through. Well, 4.7, that's what I'm expecting. But I'm not seeing a ton of carbonation bubbles rising up. It is a pretty... Well, it's frothy in the middle, but there's mixed mash bubbles on the side. White in color, head, about a finger. No floaties, of course. This is going to be thin bodied, I could already tell. Get a nose on them. So this is a pale ale. Man, it smells. It smells like a 4.7. It's not bursting with notes. It's everything's muted, dialed back, very, very faint. Kind of mainstreamish. A little like rice or wheat, like some type of grain. That's really it. I thought I'd got for you. So this is a low boy from Half Acre, number 5. So I got for you, my good man Rat. Cheers. Oh my god, I could drink like 15 of these. I could literally drink like 15 of these in a row.
Does that mean you like it?
Oh, it's very good. It you know what kind of reminds me of? Cheerios. Take a sip of that. Think of the aftertaste of Cheerios. It's real grainy.
I know you had a beer that was a Cheerios.
Yes, well, that one really was like, that was Honey Nut Cheerios. My good man, Joe from the Beer Patrol sent that one. The aftertaste. It's real, like, grainy, oaty. Think about Cheerios with no milk. Eating them as a snack.
This isn't far off from the one that you just did before, though.
No. Well, yeah. That was another single IPA, but this is a pale ale. So this is even lighter. I mean, it's very, very light. I could drink this like juice. It's crushable, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's got like a... like a pale ale mainstream vibe to it. I mean, you could literally destroy this. It's very light, very muted, grainy on the back end, bitterness extremely low, carbonation average, body is very light. There's no, like, fruit notes up front. It's real beerish, real mainstream.
Real IPA-ish.
Yeah, like mainstream, though. Like, you're not getting, like, zest or any of that. You're just picking up...
Cherry hops?
Yeah, you're not getting the fruit essence of the hops. You're getting, like, the vegetal, earthy part of the hops mixed with, like, whatever yeast or malts or grain that they've thrown in here. Very basic. Almost, all I can say is mainstream. It's a mainstream low ABV crusher made by a craft brewer. That's the best way I can describe it. Like, if I'm putting this up against a Budweiser or a Miller Lite, I'm easily going this. It's better than those.
Why would you even put it up against?
Because those are like mainstream, but they're made cheaply. This is like a mainstream made with some type of quality behind it. That's what I'm saying. So you got to try to pick. When I'm saying mainstream, I'm not talking about Coors Light and shit. I'm talking about like craft brew main. Like you said, like Dogfish, like a low ABV Dogfish or a low ABV Victory or a low ABV 21st Amendment. That's what it is.
From the taste, I would have thought that the ABV would be a little higher.
No, it's just like water. It's like water. Hop water. It's like hop water. To me, I don't know. To me, that's like hot water. I could mow the lawn and drink like 10 of these and be like, did I have beer today? What, did I just have a cold beverage?
You're exaggerating.
No, I'm not saying I wouldn't be drunk. I'm just saying taste-wise, I'd be like, I didn't feel like I drank a beer. Because beer to me is a nice, thick, hazy, creamy New England or a stout or a heavily fruited sour. Like, well, I don't really consider those beer, but they're just... very delicious alcoholic beverages, but I'm ranting now. But
let me guess, you get them all for your wife, right?
I get them for the wife. I like the sample, but I get them for the wife. Now this is like for what they're going for, 4.7%. It's absolute crusher. Like if I'm putting this up against the 4 points, all right, companies I've had that do a 4% of that at like a sub 5 that are really good, other half. Jumps to mind because I've had a couple from them. Like, wow, there's no way they're pulling this much flavor. Most companies don't even. Well, they might do it, but I don't buy it. If I see it, I don't buy stuff like that. So I don't know. Those other halves were sent to me, and they were delicious for a low sub 5 ABV. But I would put this right there with it. Not as good, a little bit lower. So for what they're going for, a pale ale 4.7. I'll give that a 4.0, for sure. If you see it, if you like low ABV, some people don't like that heavy shit. I like it. If you don't like that, you would buy this all friggin' day. You would equivalent of a case, you'd buy a 12-pack of this. So you go and you buy a case of Bud, you'd buy a 12-pack. You'd buy a couple 4-packs of that and call it a day. That's my recommendation for what they're going for. They killed it, 4.0. It won't let you down if that's what you like. Rat, my man, thank you. I'm rifling through these motherfuckers. Rifling. That's all I got for you. Peace.